Bless all children, that they may love, honor, and obey disciples were on the way, going up to Jerusalem, and Jesus went ahead of them. They were amazed, and those who followed were afraid. Taking the 12 aside again, he began to tell them what was going to happen to people. "Behold, you are going up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man will be handed over by the scribes, and they will condemn him to death, and hand him over to the Gentiles who will mock him, and spit upon him, scourge him, and put him to death. But after 3 days, he will rise." Then James and John, sons of Zebedee, came to Jesus and said to him, "Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask of you." Jesus replied, "What do you wish me to do for you?" They answered him, "Grant that in your glory we may sit one at your right and the other at your left." Jesus said to them, "You do not know what you are asking. Can you drink the chalice that I drink, or be baptized with the baptism with which I am baptized?" They said to him, "We can." Jesus said to them, "The chalice that I drink, you will drink, and with the baptism with which I am baptized, you will be baptized. But to sit at my right or at my left is not mine to give, but is for those to whom it has been prepared." When the 10 heard this, they became indignant at James and John. Jesus summoned them and said to them, "You know that those who are recognized as rulers over the Gentiles lord it over them, and their great ones make the authority over them felt. But it shall not be so among you. Rather, whoever wishes to be great among you will be your servant. Whoever wishes to be first among you will be the slave of all. For the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So we have heard today's Gospel reading about the prediction of Jesus on the way to Jerusalem. He predicted and told his disciples that the Son of Man himself undergo trials, challenges, and death. He would suffer and die on the 3rd day for the rise. The popularity of Jesus was there, and yet he also presented that even though how popular he was, performing many miracles, healing those who are sick, even expelling evil spirits, and yet he has to fulfill his role, the salvation of all, to give his life for our salvation. So while he was talking about that, about his own suffering and death, the disciples were not listening. In fact, the two sons of Zebedee, instead of listening to what Jesus was saying about his own prediction, about his own suffering and death, they were thinking in advance, "If you will be in your kingdom, be sure the two of us, I and James, will be in your right hand and your left hand." Meaning to say, be sure that when you are in your power, become a king, the two of us, the two brothers, will become generals. So they were thinking of those material possessions controlling the world. And of course, they were told about the service. So if you want to be great, you must be the servant of all. And Jesus was the only one in talking to them. His life was a perfect example of that greatness. Probably you can also have this kind of celebration with Jose Sulaiman, the role of boxing council president. He humbled himself and offered his service to the great community, especially in boxing, to train them to do something about their own lives, to elevate the kind of poverty from some people. It's a good plan. That's why our Lord Jesus was the one, when he was the one giving example to those apostles, not to be ambitious to certain things, putting down others, but rather to be ambitious to do something for the greater glory of God, to be of service to the community. And that was the call that Jesus was trying to present to them, and he himself became the example. Because the Son of Man came to this world not to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many. And that's the reason why in first reading from the letter of Peter, we realize that Peter mentioned that it was through the blood of Jesus that we are being redeemed, that through his death on the cross, salvation came to us. And he became our model and example about sacrifice. Sacrifice is not punishment. Sacrifice is not suffering, but rather doing something for others, for the good of others, and for your great love
Mother, help us.
That we may accept our responsibility in the community in a spirit of genuine service.
Loving Mother, help us.
To pray that the Holy Spirit may guide and strengthen Pope Francis, the bishops, and all the clergy.
Loving Mother, help us. Loving Mother, help us.
That we may bring knowledge and love of Christ to those who do not know.
Loving Mother, help us.
That we may be aware of our dependence on God in the midst of human achievements.
Loving Mother, help us.
That we may be ready at death to enter the home of our Heavenly Father.
Loving Mother, help us. Loving Mother, help us.
That we may be comforted at the death of our dear ones by our hope in the risen Lord.
Loving Mother, help us.
To pray that our departed brothers and sisters quickly share in your Son's resurrection.
Loving Mother, help us.
Let us pray in silence for our good intentions.
Election. It's on already.
Thank you.
truly even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked with the loneliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, the hosts of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in the presence forever. Their voices we pray to join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Thank you. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await a blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of Christ, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Kapag nakapag-umpisal.
Mag-cross ko na lang.
Sige po.